In this video, I'm going to demonstrate using if statements to make decisions in a program. I'll create three versions of a program that reads a temperature from the user and reports the state of matter for gold at that temperature to demonstrate this concept. I'll begin by writing a comment that describes the purpose of our program and a few comments that briefly outline the steps that we will take to create it. Now that the comments have been written, it's time to write Python statements. I'll start by reading the temperature from the user as a floating point number and storing it in a variable named temp, which is my abbreviation for temperature. I'm going to ignore the work needed to identify the state of matter for the moment and go ahead and write the code needed to display the result. This print statement uses a variable named state that I haven't yet assigned a value. I'll have to make sure that it's assigned a value when I go back and fill in the middle section of our program. There are three states of matter for gold that can be determined from its temperature. If the temperature is less than the melting point, then the gold is a solid. If the temperature is between the melting point and the boiling point, then it's a liquid. If the temperature is greater than or equal to the boiling point, then it's a gas. Our program needs to store the appropriate word, solid, liquid, or gas, into the state variable. In the first version of our program, I'll use three if statements to reach this goal. The first if statement will check if the gold is solid. An if statement begins with the word if. That's followed by a condition that evaluates to either true or false. In this case, my condition will use the less than relational operator to compare the temperature to the melting point. A colon always appears immediately after the condition. The if statement is followed by one or more lines of code that will only execute when the condition evaluates to true. These lines of code are referred to as the body of the if statement, and they must be indented more than the word if. In this example, the body will be an assignment statement that stores the string solid in the state variable. Now I'll write a second if statement that will check if the gold is a gas. It compares the temperature entered by the user to the boiling point using the greater than or equal operator. The body of this if statement stores gas in the state variable. The if statement that determines if the gold is liquid is a little bit more complicated. It needs to verify that the temperature entered by the user is both greater than or equal to the melting point and less than the boiling point. We'll use two relational operators to express these requirements and then combine the results using Python's AND operator. The AND operator evaluates to true if and only if both the expression to its left and the expression to its right are true. In this case, that will ensure that the temperature is within the liquid range. The body of this if statement will also be an assignment statement that stores the appropriate string in the state variable. Let's see what happens when we run our program. When the user enters a temperature below the melting point, the condition on the first if statement evaluates to true, and the body of the if statement executes, storing solid in the state variable. The condition on the second if statement evaluates to false, which causes Python to skip over the body of the if statement without executing it. Similarly, Python skips the body of the third if statement because its condition also evaluates to false. If we run our program again and enter a temperature greater than or equal to the boiling point, then Python evaluates the first condition and determines that it's false, causing it to skip the body of the first if statement. Similarly, it evaluates the condition for the second if statement, determines that it's also false, and skips the body of the second if statement. The condition on the third if statement is true, so Python runs its body and stores gas into the state variable. Running our program for a third time demonstrates that it also reports the correct result when the temperature is between the melting point and the boiling point. In this version of the program, we used three if statements, one of which included a complex condition, to solve the problem. While this solution generates correct results, it's easy to make a mistake when writing the conditions. Our intention is that exactly one of the three bodies will run for any temperature entered by the user. But a single character error, such as using greater than where greater than or equal should have been used, can result in either two bodies running or no bodies running. So Python provides other kinds of if statements that help us simplify the conditions and ensure that exactly one body runs each time the program executes. I will create a second version of our program to demonstrate this. An if-else statement allows a program to choose between one of two alternatives. It begins with the word if, followed by a condition, a colon, and the body of the if statement. The body of the if statement is followed by the word else, a colon, and the else statement's body. When the if statement's condition is true, the body of the if statement executes, and the body of the else statement is skipped. When the if statement's condition is false, the body of the if statement is skipped, and the body of the else statement is executed. When the gold is not solid, we need to do more work to determine if it's a liquid or a gas. This additional work can be performed by nesting a second if-else statement inside the body of the else statement. The nested if-else statement is indented so that Python knows that it's inside the body of the outer else. The condition on the inner if-else statement will check if the temperature is less than the boiling point. If so, it will set the state to liquid. Otherwise, it will set the state to gas. Notice that we do not need a complex condition on this if statement because the body of the outer else only executes when the temperature of the gold is greater than or equal to the melting point. Let's see what happens when we run this version of our program. When the user enters a temperature that's less than the melting point, Python runs the body of the outer if statement and sets the state to solid. The entire body of the outer else statement is skipped, and Python displays the correct result. When the user enters a temperature that's between the melting point and the boiling point, Python skips the body of the outer if statement and executes the body of the outer else statement. It evaluates the condition of the inner if statement, determines that it's true, and sets the state to liquid. Since the body of the inner if statement was executed, the body of the inner else statement is skipped, and Python goes on and displays the correct result. When the user enters a temperature greater than the boiling point, Python skips the body of the outer if statement because its condition is false and executes the body of the outer else statement. It also skips the body of the inner if statement because its condition also evaluates to false. This causes the body of the inner else statement to run, setting the state to gas. As you can see, these programs generate the same results, but there are fewer comparisons in the second version. In some programs, it's necessary to select one of many alternatives instead of one of just three alternatives. While nested if-else statements can be used, they become difficult to read as each additional option is indented further than its predecessor. Python uses the else-if construct, which it abbreviates to elif, to overcome the indenting problem. I will create a third version of our program that demonstrates its use. Like the other if statements that we considered, an if-elif-else statement begins with if, followed by a condition, colon, and body. The body of the if is followed by one or more elif statements. In this case, we'll use an elif statement to check if the gold is liquid, and an else statement to take care of the case where the gold is a gas. Let's see what happens when we run this version of the program. When the user enters a temperature that's less than the melting point, Python begins by evaluating the condition on the if statement. Since the condition evaluates to true, Python runs the body of the if statement, setting the state to solid, and then skips all of the remaining elif and else bodies. The next line of code that executes is the print statement that displays the result. When the user enters a temperature that is between the melting point and the boiling point, Python begins by evaluating the condition on the if statement. Since the condition evaluates to false, Python skips the body of the if statement and goes on and checks the condition on the elif statement. This condition evaluates to true, so Python executes the body of the elif statement, skips the body of the else statement, and then goes on and displays the result. When the user enters a temperature greater than the boiling point, Python begins by evaluating the condition on the if statement. It's false, so Python skips the body of the if statement and goes on to evaluate the condition on the elif statement. It's also false, which causes Python to skip the body of the elif statement and execute the body of the else statement, setting the state to gas. Finally, Python goes on and displays the result. These programs have demonstrated if statements with complex conditions, nested if-else statements, and if-elif-else statements. I hope that watching this video has increased your understanding of these topics.